students, it's time for the class, is it? Sorry, I'm little late. I went to the market to bought some vegetables. So have a little work more. We will start our class after finishing my work. Can you help me to complete my work fast? Then only we could start the class easily. Okay, students, I reached home. And if you help me, we could start the class. So this is the work. I have bought some vegetables. We have to arrange these vegetables. Okay, I want to keep these vegetables inside the refrigerator. So for that, we have to arrange these vegetables. So let us put the same items together. Let us take the onions and put the onions together. Have separate basket for this. So now take the potato. Now potatoes, put the potatoes together. Okay, now have some tomatoes. Two tomatoes are there. So put the tomatoes together. Now the ginger. Okay, ginger together. Now here are some chilies. Okay, now we arrange the things. So we arrange the different things together. Okay, so onions together, potatoes together, ginger and this tomato together. So students, thank you. You all helped me. So now let me keep these vegetables in my refrigerator. I will be back soon. Okay, so wait, be ready for the class. So welcome to the Max class, students. Thank you so much. You helped me very well as you help your mother. Is it? You all help your mothers at your home to fold the dresses, to arrange the study table, and like that you help me too. How you used to arrange your books in your bag? Yes, you will arrange it in an order. Is it, students? We will put the textbook together first. Then we will put the notebooks together. And while arranging the notebooks also, we will put it on its height order. Is it? So students, arranging the things neatly or putting same type things together is called sorting. Okay, so arranging the things can be termed as sorting, putting the same items together, sorting. Today's Max class, we are going to discuss about arranging and sorting. All of you look at this board. You can see some fruits here. Which are the fruits here? Strawberry, bananas, then pear, watermelon, cherries. Very good. So I am giving this information to you. You have to find out the numbers of each fruits. Okay, how many bananas are there? How many cherries are there? Okay, are you ready? Okay, let's do it together. Before that, just listen. The information I'm giving to you is known as data. What will we call this information? It is data. D-A-T-A. Data means information. So, the given information or the data can be presented in the form of list or tables. Okay, so this is called arranging and presenting the given data in a table or in a list is called data handling. And today we are going to study our lesson, data handling. How to handle the data. Okay, so just we have to count the numbers and write it in a list, in the form of a list or in a table. That is data handling. Now look at this picture. You can see the same data I given to you. So all of you take your notebook and pencils and write down strawberries and count it and write the number of strawberries there. How many cherries are there? Let's count together. 1, 2, 3. There are 3 cherries. So, cherries are 3 in number. All of you write that. Now, how many bananas are there? Count it. 1, 2, 3, 4,
5. Excellent. 5 bananas are there. And how many pears? Yes, 2 pears. Excellent. And now how many watermelon? 1, 2, 3, 4. It's an easy task. So, all we have to do is just count the number of things and write it like this. And write the number. That is what we have to do for this data handling. And I am putting this data on a table and giving headings to it. The first heading, items. Okay. So the first column is items and second one, number of items. Number of items. So listen, students, when we get some information, that is called data, and when we are arranging the data in a table or in the form of a list, it is called data handling. So this is an easy task. All of you know how to count the numbers of things. You have to just write it like this. So this is called data handling. Okay, data handling. So students, by sorting and arranging the same type together, it will be very easy to locate and find things easily. So we must always keep things neatly arranged. So students, I hope all you understood today's class. Here is the activity for you. All of you just watch the video again and make a data table of the vegetables which I have shown in the beginning of the video. You can choose any 4 vegetables from my vegetable bag and count the numbers and make a data table. Students, catch you in the next class. Thank you.